What's up, guys? MrGimms back again for another DEADBY. Hope everyone's feeling all right. All right. But anyway, guys. Hey, how you doing? You're back. Where have you been?
Lord Tony is gone, so I must live.
Well, it's good to have you back, dude. Sauce? It's good to have you back, man. It's good to have you back. You just do that sometimes? You just go away for a while? Is that what you do? You're one of those guys.
I am now SOT.
What's with the black robe? Jesus Christ. Leave your entries in the forums below, and I'll read your opinions in the next episode of DEADBY. Alright, cheaters are completely out of control. Yeah, I definitely agree. It's been quite the week for it, hasn't it? Literally. Straight off the get-go. Literally. They have started streaming on Twitch. They haven't started streaming on Twitch. They haven't started. They have been for quite some time, actually. I can't send the channel link because the forums mods get mad. We do not permit the naming of shaming of anyone. Yeah, because they're It's insane that in 2021, this game almost fully client-side, basically everything the client will do will be accepted by the server. Yeah. For example, I'm playing Ghostface. I tell the game by injecting into the process. You got weird terminology. So from client-side to throw... Okay, the grammar isn't very good either. Server. Oh, okay. See, everything seems fine. He must be throwing a hat. I know what you're trying to say. You're trying to... The server check marks. Yeah, I gotcha. Yeah. There are literally... I can't make this shit up. No checks from the server. This literally sucks. Yeah, they're terrible. They're awful. Awful devs in terms of making a game. Another problem is related to the anti-cheat. The anti-cheat doesn't work. It's pretty simple. Easy anti-cheat is literally a joke. Yeah, it says it in its name. Easy anti-cheat. Just load a single assigned kernel driver. Assigned kernel driver. That is interesting. And I feel free to inject do what you... Okay, whatever. When will behavior stop making everything client-side? When will the spaghetti code end? Probably never. So yeah, at the end, if you're facing many cheaters, that's the reason. Okay, this guy was all over the shop. I encountered 3 in less than 24 hours. It's pretty crazy from the anti-cheat software. It's trash. I do agree. Yeah, I've had 2 in 2 months, and that's actually exponentially larger than what I normally have.
You were outplayed.
I was just outplayed. You like Charlie, are you? Good one, mate. I've encountered 3 to 4 in the past 3,800 hours. That's how I used to be. I'd probably encountered about 5 in 5 years. And then this month and last month, I've encountered 1 on each month. So, you know, going by those stats, it is going up slightly. But it's going up enough, you know what I mean? I have recorded, streamed every match I've played in DVD. Okay. Again, 4 hackers in 3,800 hours, all reported. If I or my chat have suspected more, I would have reported them. Like most things on these forums, I think some people's accounts of how many hackers they have encountered are exaggerated. I do agree with you on that one. One-upmanship is pretty prevalent on these forums after all. I totally agree, actually. That's really well said, too.
Let the game burn.
I encountered another one an hour ago. He head-on stunned me for 2 minutes. Yeah, that's the thing. That's the thing that Cardi B likes to do, the massive stun.
Stuns should be for 2 minutes.
Should be for 2 minutes, do you think, normally? I don't miss you anymore. Flashlight blinded me across the map, had unlimited endurance status, etc. The other survivors went to report. I didn't. I'm done sending in reports. And then still seeing the same cheaters play months later. Behavior doesn't care. Do they? It's hard to... Do they? I don't know, man. It's weird. Hacking David. Okay. I'll watch it. Why not? How long? I hope it's just a clip and not a whole video, though. It's a 7-minute video. Christ. Horton's level. David falls from the sky. Really? Is that a thing? I wasn't paying attention. He definitely fell from the sky. Wow. That's pretty funny. Seems legit so far, apart from the falling out of the sky. normal loops. Whoa! Okay, alright, I'm starting to see someone here. Took a legit hit then. I mean, obviously he's hacking, we can see that. There's just like little minor tweaks, like obviously that was over the top there for that little second, but I feel like hackers are getting smarter too and covering their tracks. Right on. Oh my god. He can just jump. Wait, he still goes down and he's hacking. What a fucking loser. What a fucking loser gets a trap and he's hacking. Yeah, what an absolute loser.
David needs better hacks.
Get a grip. Would you use a rematch option if it was available? That's kind of cool. That's kind of cool, yeah. I could see that. In a competitive scene, I could see that being good. Just a button at the end of the game that puts you back in a lobby with the same players who want a rematch could solve some of the lobby wait time issues. Honestly, that's not horrible. It's not a horrible idea. I mean, obviously, when you know a proper MMR is working, this would be good. But I don't know. It's cool, though. Only if you could switch killers. Would be nice to have a rematch with the shit talking teabaggers and okay, so you want to switch killer. That would also be cool. Like ready up, have like a tick by your name when you're ready to go, and then like you can pick your killer and your survivor and your loadout and stuff. Yeah, reload out. That's cool. I like that as well. I mean, yeah, if you're playing against the same survivors, then MMR doesn't really matter anymore. Not necessarily, because you don't know how MMR works then, if that's what you're saying. MMR works on a skill-based point, and when you win, your points go up. So it does matter. So if you beat the same people with the same roundabouts MMR as you, you still go up. You know what I mean? It will stop after a while though, because you've beaten that level of competition. But yeah, that's cool. People get so lucky they don't even know. Also, I try to appeal with the salt. I try to appease the salt within. a true Lord Tony in the works. F in the chat for Lord Tony, man. Hashtag free Tony, guys. Free Tony.
Free our Lord and Savior. Tony.
I need a friend, mobile version. Okay. Oh god, she's already on it, is she? Haven't you done enough damage, Mandy? Oh my god, the discussion is closed. You're so shit. Hi, I'm Maya. My rank is 7 and my lowest rank is 3. I need friends to play with. DBD Maya K, Discord Maya K. Yeah, this is just one of those looking for friends posts, which is pretty funny. I'm gonna like it. So she's looking for friends on mobile, okay. This forum is for the core game only, so PC and console. For anything related to DBD Mobile, please use their official sources, which is this Discord. You may also find players to play on with there. So you literally closed down a discussion about somebody trying to find some friends in Dead by Daylight? Are you against having friends, Mandy Talks?
Mandy is a kind, loving DBD mod.
Why do you love everything I swear to destroy?
Destroy Mandy.
Why the date change? I changed the date? Why is the sale ending September 1st? Ah, the Stranger Things thing. Okay, cool. Why is the sale ending September 1st when this is going to be the original date? I'm confused. Right. Outfit sale. This does not include the DLC itself. A tad strange, but have they actually changed the date? We talked about this on stream today. Oh, so the outfit sale is still happening. I'm confused about these dates. Wednesday the 1st. Yeah. Oh, Mandy Talk corrects us here, doesn't she? Yep, I'm just double checking with the team. You don't type that as you're double checking, Mandy. Makes you look incompetent. What you do is you ask them first and then give them the answer. But the DLC sale ends on 1st September, and I believe you're so unsure about anything, aren't you? And you work there. And I believe the outfit sales end on the 8th September, the in-game sales. That's the information that I have. I am double checking that this is correct now. What do you mean you're double checking? You are a behavior mod. How are you double checking? That's the information you have. Shouldn't you be privy to all the information that of the goings on of stuff that would be needed to be known on the forums? Wouldn't you think? Okay. Wow. Oh, okay. She gets back to us. Nope. No last minute changes have been made. DLC sale ends 1st of September. In-game character sale ends November 17th. In-game cosmetics ends on the 8th. Right. You have no idea what you're doing, and it's really funny. It's really funny. To me, anyway. Go on. Such a loser. Can we please have the ability to go into a custom games alone? So have bots? Title, it would be nice to be able to wander the maps with no pressure or to learn loops. Yeah, that's cool. Yeah. Yeah, you don't even want bots. You're easy to please. Yeah, he just wants to be able to roam around and get better.
He needs to get better, lol.
That's what he's trying to do. You got a problem with that?
You should do that too.
Guess if you're a survivor, you can escape through hatch or do gen and open a gate. If you're a killer, because there is no survivor left, the game instantly ends. Which is why they don't give us the ability to custom games alone. I really want this because, no, that you're an idiot. No, that's not why they do it. They'd be able to do something to stop that from happening, mate. How do you think that's the reason why they haven't done it? It's laziness, dude. It's laziness. They'd be able to do something where there would be no endgame collapse and you can just leave when you're ready to leave in a custom match. God. This should have been a thing for years. Yeah, I don't understand why they can't quickly add this to the game. It's kind of silly for me. Blight is being overlooked by the one and only cringy Sluzzy. Here we go. Always an essay too, isn't it?
Sluzzy must be destroyed.
I am convinced he somehow is ignored because of all the newbies playing him is lowering his performance on the charts. Right. Or perhaps he is ignored regardless of how... Alright, so that first point is useless now. Of how often he has played and the many complaints he is receiving and there's nothing being done. The way Blight plays with the same boring perk build that totally suppresses survivors. He loves that. Suppresses survivors. There is absolutely no opportunity to escape. The learning curve is too small and Blights are overpowered. Survivors, I don't know. I love it how he cares about Blight and like... I don't want to say anything because the devs listen to him. At least I think they do. Okay. But, you know, there's things like nurse and stuff like that. It's just weird how he's had a bad day against a blight, you can tell. Just like he did have a bad day against the Wraith recently. Survivors are nerfed when it's unfun or perceived too strong when killers say so. It is time for the killer is nerfed and not ignored. Not talking about adding a millisecond to his recharge time. I'm tired of playing him 9 out of 10 times in a sweaty red rank mode and have zero chances of escaping. Ruin Tinkerer Pop Barbecue is ignored and needs looking into. God, you're boring. The too many slowdown perks and tracking perks like these that can be everywhere with no cooldowns. Too many slowdown and tracking perks on these killers that can be everywhere with no cooldowns. He's a killer, that's what he's gonna do, mate. Track you down and hold the game. He has no cooldown after traveling completely across the map. He does have a cooldown. He instantly moves at full 4.6 speed. How is that balanced? Tinkerer told him where to go. Blight needs a nerf and those perks because they are a huge problem. He shouldn't regain his stacks almost instantly. Okay, right on. And have much more penalty for using his power. It is too oppressive. And the post has been edited by our one and only favorite game eyes. Yeah, you're wrong. Just so you know. And to think I just barely 2K'd on Swamp as him because literally half the trees don't have collision and they kept making me lose chases. Yeah, exactly. He doesn't talk about those issues though, does he? Agreed, you probably will get mocked by Blight mains and fanboys. Okay. Who don't want to lose their express card to easy 4K. His recharge per token should be at least doubled. That would be a neat start. Awesome. You are biased. Blight is okay. He needs a couple of add-ons nerfing, in my opinion, but I don't think his base kit is a problem at all. The real issue is the weakness and lack of coordination of solo survivor. That's what should be addressed. A solo survivor can be really good at the game, you know what I mean? So, I don't know what that means. Like, if he's gonna have Tinkerer, he's gonna have Tinkerer. You know what I mean? It doesn't matter if you're solo or in a survivor of friends. What's that do for you? I don't really get that. I do agree with solo survivor, though. They need to do something with it.
Blight is perfect balanced.
Haddonfield is extremely overrated. You think? No way in hell is Haddonfield near the best map for survivors. It's one of, mate. Everyone complains about it, and there isn't anything on that that's very good at all. There are a few good things about it, like a couple of good palettes, but almost every map has those. I think you're missing out on three quarters of the map there, buddy. Heights are generally bad for survivors because of the fall stun, and it's a very vertical map. Maybe back in the day it was better when balanced landing was OP, but without that it's not very good. Batum is better in basically every way. It's bigger, has more safe palettes, has better buildings, has amazing main building. Again, I think you're skipping a lot of the map problems. Also, Bantam is really strong for survivors. Sure, I mean, every house is a pain and can sometimes spawn infinites, but sure. Oh yeah, and Great Walls of China and all the safe pallets and the massive size of the map. But yeah, I guess it's just overrated. And it's been edited all by himself. Okay, thank God. Are you forgetting the God window that can spawn in the Myers house? Yeah, what about the God window? What about that really OP window? Probably the strongest loop in the entire game, right? It's probably one of the near infinites. No, he just says that. It's probably one of the near infinites.
Haven field is perfect balanced.
Shut up, mate. Come on. If it's so overrated, then why do I see Haddonfield offering so many times? It's like the most common in my experience, 100%. I had Haddonfield 4 times on the stream the other night. Yeah, I think it's really strong for survivors. I don't know what's going on here. This guy's just a bit of a douchebag, I think. Or he's just, you know, comfortably numb. Who moved this here? Oh, what the hell? I know this is probably being mentioned before, but even to this day, I have no explanation as to why the heck Leary's has a cow. Anyone able to help me understand this? I've never noticed that. Peanuts. Yes, that's Moo Moo. Moo Moo is sleeping. Nobody can convince me that she isn't sleeping. Why are all the devs just so lame? I don't know. Is it just me? Bad taste. But anyway, guys, that's going to do it for DEADBY this week. Hope you guys did enjoy. Don't forget, you can submit your own DEADBY submissions in the Discord in the link down below. And maybe your DEADBY forum submission will be in the next episode of DEADBY. It's good to have you back, even though you've annoyed the shit out of me for tonight. Don't get the black robe. It's pretty ominous and creepy. But yeah, he's back, and I don't know for how long. I guess we'll see. But anyway, guys, thanks so much for watching. Really appreciate it. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe if you did enjoy it and you want to see more. And I'll see you guys next week. Have a great weekend.